I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
Well, the controversy continued over the water in the La Ronda area, with hundreds, perhaps, of homes that were without water for several days. In Wolf Lakes, one subdivision for 3 days. Anyway, Don Marshall from the Parish Water District was on hand, and now you've been through the Parish Council meeting. First, where does the Eastern Heights Water Company, where does all that stand at this moment?
So, we did speak with their CPA this morning, myself and our general manager, Charles Schlicker, and our CPA. They are getting all of, they're supposed to send all of their documents digitally to us either today or tomorrow, as well as some legal documents that we've been waiting on. And then our CPA and our attorney will have to go over all of those documents.
Once this is to facilitate the actual sale.
To facilitate the potential takeover, correct, of Eastern Heights. That is correct.
So you need the paperwork, and now you've been assured you're going to get it.
That's what it sounds like. They said that they're going to send it over digitally today or tomorrow. I was expecting it today. I haven't heard anything back yet, but I haven't had a lot of time to be on the phone just to make sure that the paperwork came over, because there was a lot of other things been dealing with.
That's part of the irony of this whole catastrophe over Christmas, is that the merger was in the works months ago.
It was in the works, and it does take, because they do have some USDA loans. There are certain financials that we have to make sure are in line, and there are certain legal hoops that have to be jumped through. We should be getting that paperwork, like I said, today or tomorrow. Either we should have received it actually today or get it tomorrow. That'll help us get through those hoops. Once all of that's done, we also have to have approval from the Louisiana Public Service Commission. I spoke with Public Service Commissioner Eric Scometter several times today. And he's assured me that he will do everything within his power, that once those hoops are jumped through, that he will get it on the agenda as soon as possible to approve the takeover.
One of the things that happened during this crisis was, at the end, the Water District was invited in to send some expertise, and you guys were Johnny on the spot getting there with your superintendent. You were there personally. Where does the actual repairing of the Eastern Heights system for the time being stand?
I think that's a better question for Eastern Heights. I can tell you that right before the council meeting started, I had gotten a text from my general manager, who had notified me that they were back up to 45 pounds per square inch. The well runs up until it hits 54 pounds per square inch. It's a 100,000 gallon tank. So that is about 10 foot of water in that tank is what it is. It dropped down to, I want to say, 38 PSI earlier today, somewhere around 11 o'clock this morning. So it was back up to 45. It takes about an hour and a half for every pound per square inch to go up.
Well, Councilman Carlo Bruno said they found one big leak coming out of a 2-inch pipe that was in the woods. And I've heard that there were other leaks found. So over time, that's bound to help.
Oh, absolutely, that'll help. That'll absolutely help. But at the end of the day, that well pumps 210 gallons per minute at 100,000 gallon tank. You know, that's an 8-hour, 9-hour job to fill it. It got drained, whether it be from the drip in the water or the brakes or the combination. It's hard to tell right now until you do an after action assessment of it. I can tell you, though, as La Ronda grows, they're going to need more than a 210-gallon per minute pump.
Of course, here's the good news. You folks at the Water District have a line within half a mile of that wellhead. So the takeover, the solving of the problem, at least for the time being, is not that far away.
Well, almost. We have 9/10 of a mile from the La Ronda Fire Station to the La Ronda supermarket on Highway 40, which is where we can connect. We'd have to run one line there to connect in. That would loop their, that would put their system, tie it into our system. We could also run, it is also the potential that we could run a line up Poles Road and Cook Road, which would then create a semi-loop into the system. So it would be three endpoints from our system into the Eastern Heights system if we were to take it over.
So you have some options, and also in the long run, maybe it won't even be that long, you're going to put some new wells in.
Well, we do have the Highway 40 West Highway 40 West well that's already been approved contract, and that's already started. Now, that doesn't mean the ground's been broke. It just means the process has started. The Highway 40 East well, we are now looking for land. Now, we're getting with our engineers to see if we're going to take the Eastern Heights Water District over, if maybe it will be better off suited to move that well and tank closer to the LaRange area as opposed to where we were originally going to put it.
So this is, I mean, this is the answer. This is the solution. Everyone agrees.
Yeah, I think this is the ultimate. I think this would be the best solution if the accounting comes back accurate and with the USDA approval the legal work. All that would be left after that would be the Public Service Commission, which I'm sure our Public Service Commissioner here, Eric Scrimeta, would make sure and got approved on that end.
I just think we're lucky that unlike St. Tammany, unlike a lot of parishes that maybe are ahead of us in some categories, years ago, our parish created the parish-wide water district and the sewer district so that utilities, as much a part of modern life as anything, can be provided even in rural areas.
Yes, that is true, Ken, and I'll tell you this. Look, the Tangipahoa Parish Water District system, We didn't have any loss of water. We didn't have any loss of pressure. I think we had a few minor breaks, but those were fixed relatively fast. No one was out of water. But it's my understanding that Tick Fall was out of water. Maurepaugh was out of water. Eastern Heights was out of water. St. Tammany had a boil water advisory out. St. John had a boil water advisory out. St. James had a boil water advisory out. So everyone around us had boil water advisories out, and we were fortunate enough that we planned far enough ahead of the Tangipahoa Water District that we did not have to put a boil water advisory out, and all of our customers were kept with water.
What else do you want to tell us?
Well, I hope everyone had a Merry Christmas, even those in the Eastern Heights District. I hope y'all had a Merry Christmas, even with that unfortunate incident. I'm glad y'all have water back now. I hope everybody has a Happy New Year, and I hope it's even more prosperous for Tangipahoa Parish and all of the residents than it was this year.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am Attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangilawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.